Hello everyone and welcome to Tankfront Red Alert Online, which is, from what I know, not affiliated with Red Alert Online or Red Alert, that is. It's not a Chinese war game, naturally, and we are facing one big tank here. That tank has a lot of turrets, and some of these turrets have double barrels, and we've got two pitiful tanks here. This does not look good, does it? Or maybe it does. Nope, we don't seem to deal any damage here. This is of course just an introductory battle or cutscene. Ooh, look at that, we've got our Tesla tank here. So this game does... And what is that thing in the lower right hand corner there? That looks like some sort of gigantic firecracker on wheels. Yep, and it turns out that really huge tank maybe isn't so tough. And just got electrocuted. Nice, nice. Yeah, this is another one of those games. There's our standard women in the uniform. And here's our tutorial section, also known as the click on the shiny buttons click section. Here, let's see whether we have any lifted assets here. We do seem to have the Tesla tank. That looks like the Red Alert one. I guess the Red Alert 3 one. Those look fairly similar. We do have a little base here where there's vehicles. Oh, those make very sharp turns. And here's our map where we go from section to section. So I can't even tell which of these games is ripping off which one, because they're all just so samey. You've got these semi-automated battles, you've got your upgrade systems, you've got your bases that don't really matter. And there we go. That was quick. That took about 2 seconds. Exciting, exciting. We get experience here. And now we can, I presume, upgrade our base. Yeah, there we go. Of course, there's no actual base building. We just click on icons and upgrade our gigantic cogwheel. Well, that's not really a cogwheel. That looks more like some sort of buzzsaw. I guess that's some sort of mining wheel, whatever the term for that is. All derrick, of course. That was to be expected. And is that the generator, possibly? We shall see. In any case, I'm always glad for these tutorial sections here, because otherwise these games would be largely unplayable for me, because as in previous videos, I cannot read Mandarin. Here's our commander character, and we can level him up. And then there's all these kinds of things here that you get for battles and whatnot, these resources and whatnot. None of which are truly important, but they're kind of made important because you need to gather them. But they're not terribly fun to use, to be perfectly honest. And oh, look at that. We've got some very suave looking black guy here. We have a ginger woman in questionable clothes. We have another uniformed woman. We have a somewhat generic looking guy. Is that supposed to be a pirate uniform? And yeah, this guy here again. We have an Asian woman. And we have a blonde woman. And we also have some more boy band members here. Is that Chris Redfield? I don't think he is. We also have this guy here. Yeah, I'm not quite sure from which model website they lifted those guys here. Let's go with this guy here. That seemed to be our standard character. He's already level 2. I don't know if it really makes any difference whether or not... Ooh, there we go. Oh, look. Yeah, this guy here is not quite lifted from Command Conquer Generals 2 promotional art, but he looks like a modified version of one of the European commanders. But the European commander is way older. I think that's the one from the Standard Army, maybe. In any case, apparently this newspaper here got some Facebook likes. There's also a WeChat option here. Next loot crate arrives in 26 seconds. Exciting. Shall we wait for that? Maybe. Maybe we should. Or should I click on this? Or should I click on that rucksack? Or maybe the shopping basket here? Or that Soviet tank? Who knows? Let's just wait for that loot box counter to drop down. We may as well see what exciting things we get here. And then we can see whether we can build anything. And no, clicking on these blank building icons here doesn't really seem to do anything. We do have these guys here driving in circles for whatever purpose. Alright, we get 3 tanks as well as 10,000 pink Tiberian Trams 3. Awesome. So, next loot box comes in 5 minutes. That's not actually as much as I thought. Not interested in this. This is some sort of... Can we get another present here? I guess we can. Well, look at that. Any messages here? Yeah, I'm just going to click on these icons here. I guess, oh, we leveled up. What a happy sound effect they had for that. Alright, and we're back to tutorializing, I assume. Let's see. I guess we can upgrade our stuff here. And we can get more loot boxes. We get 500 tank EXP. Exciting, exciting. I know these games want to give you stuff. Like, they just want to give you a lot of stuff, but there's just way too much stuff for the most part. First level radar dish. My favorite kind of radar dish. Yep, just following the buttons here. No worries. So can we... Does this increase our sight radius or something? Maybe it does, maybe it doesn't. I guess it doesn't really, because there's no fog of war or anything in this game here. Ooh, third level radar dish. Plus 6%. Exciting, exciting. Okay, so ooh, we've got some tanks rolling through here as well. So we do have whatever that actually is. I guess here we can upgrade our tank or whatever. But what we're actually interested in is fighting some more battles. So I guess we are hanging around here. Or, oh, do we have to fight multiple battles in the same area first? Well, we shall see. Ooh, we can get a level 3 rocket or something. Whatever. I'm just going to try to find the button that allows me to progress here. Can I do stuff here? I can move these around. Does that do anything? We shall see. Well. Oh, so no, this guy is in the front row. I probably want to do, probably should do that the other way around, but never mind. Yeah, I think this was a mistake. But it's okay. I think we can still win this because, yeah, we're just better, and this is one of those earlier battles. Got a 3-star victory here. So we should probably get, probably change our formation here. So, ooh, how do I get back to the formation window? Huh, that's a good question. Maybe if we just leave this window here, then return. And let's see, no, or if I... Oh, yeah, there we go, yeah, okay. All right, let's switch these guys around a little bit. So this game actually allows you to do that. That is nice, I assume. There we go, that's a lot better. So we have an enemy tank here that's different from ours, but they all look like main battle tanks, I assume. And can my missile guy actually fire? It doesn't look like it, so I assume my missile guy cannot fire from the second row. Oh, he can. Yeah, there we go. I guess maybe being the second row lowers your... Can I put anything down here? Is that a... Oop, whoop. Well, that just happened. Never mind. I thought I could... No, I guess I can't add any of these tanks here, can I? No, I guess if I can add anything here, then it will be shown here. All right, let's just continue. We can probably do this until we run into a brick wall. Ooh, we have got level 4 tanks or 4 tanks. This is a Heroes of Might and Magic thing where this indicates the number of your vehicles. Maybe, maybe not. It's not that important. Let's just see whether or not we win. Can we increase the speed here? We can. Boom. So that doesn't destroy all of them, but it seems we're still... Yeah, it seems the numbers indicate the numbers of vehicles. At least they do go down, so that kind of implies that. There we go. And that was still a 3-star victory. And we win experience, a golden eagle, and a dossier. Okay. So let's see. Ooh, we're facing whatever these are. Can we add new guys? So this is just blank. Don't have any pink herbarium here. Or coins, for that matter. So this... I don't know what any of this is. Let's just go. We may as well fight until we run into dead ends. So these guys here are getting a little bit tougher. Or at least there's more of them. My guys still seem to be better. Maybe because the guys I have here, those are actually seem to be a better kind of tank. Oh well, just gonna go here. Maybe you can upgrade stuff at our base now. Let's see about that. How do we get back to that? Ooh, this is somewhat confusing. Oh yeah, here we go. All right, 7 seconds until the next loot box. That's something, I guess. Some guys running around here with dogs, of course. So let's see, what do we get this time? We get 3 tanks. Twice 30,000 barrels of oil and the Book of Kings. Exciting, exciting. So anything we can do here? Doesn't look like it. This is just allow us to check how much we have. It seems like it. Okay, what does this mean? I don't know, but we'll find out in 8 seconds. Or will we? Let's see about that. At least this game seems to allow me to do something before the half hour mark. Did we upgrade our building here? Maybe we did. Whatever. Let's just wait for that. Ooh, we can actually do stuff here. Maybe that's what the upgrade does us. So we have already one of every kind. Let's just go with another mining thingy here. There we go. And can we... I guess we can get another oil thingy as well. Can we upgrade the existing ones? Maybe. Okay, so this one here is... It has to be upgraded. Yeah, this is the usual stuff. Where... Okay. Is this some sort of crystal processor? Maybe. Well, let's see about that. That took a 1 second countdown. Exciting. So let's just upgrade this until we can't anymore. I'm not quite sure what this thing does, but I assume it's good. Quote unquote. There we go, level two, and in the near future we're probably not going to be able to upgrade this anymore. But can we do anything here? Can we make our vehicles better or whatnot? So we can get more tank EXP here. Not quite sure what any of these does, but it seems we have to reach level 25 or level 10 or whatever to access any of this. We could go and spend coins here. What is this? Ooh, okay. Never mind that then. Yeah. What is this? No, just the same thing. Yeah, let's not bother with this right now. Is this interactable? Yeah, these radar domes here. Just give me a message. Can we build anything here? Nope, doesn't look like it either. And apart from that, we do have our tanks hanging around here. So we do have a couple of these. So can we upgrade or increase our vehicle pool here? Maybe. This seems to be asleep. Whatever that means. Let's see. Maybe we can upgrade this hangar or factory or whatever that is. And then get access to more exciting things. Such as more vehicles. That would be nice. But they might not give that to us before we... Ooh, there we go. I guess we did get some sort of upgrade here. Can we upgrade that as well? I guess we cannot, or at least we don't seem to be able to do that right now. Got some planes here, flying rather low. That's okay, so this is now level 3, and I guess we can't upgrade anymore until we level up or whatever. So can we actually buy anything here? I guess we can. And for 3 coins we can speed this up, so let's speed it up. Or can we? Okay. Whatever that actually did, I'll take it. This one here is not something we can use right now. Okay, so just... Oh, now we have 50 of these. Okay, that sounds good to me. Can we utilize those? Well, we shall see about that. What is this? More slots, maybe? Possibly. Ooh, what does any of this mean? I don't quite know. But did we get anything for that? I'm not quite sure. You know what? Let's just fight the next battle. I'll see whether anything here changed. So, okay, so we've got these guys here. Oh, we do have our 40 tanks here. And we can just put these here. Nice, I suppose. So, yeah, let's just go for it. Just see what happens. So they've got a fair amount of stuff, but so do we. Can we speed this up even more? No, we can't. So let's go at triple speed, because it's not like I'm actually doing anything here. Oh, we actually lost something. Look at that. So I guess we have reached a stage where we can't just win every battle easily. That's okay. There we go. We've almost blasted them away, and here we go. Still a 3-star victory. Okay, there's one more of these here. It seems we get our vehicles back after we... Okay, so we can get more of these guys here, but they seem to be rather basic. But these three in the top are on the bottom one, those are the same, so we may as well put some of these here. and some of these here, and maybe some of these here. Yeah, it seems you can only have 9 in one group. The question is, do we want to replace the guy in the center right with 9 of these guys here, or do we not want to do that? Let's maybe get the group of 3 in there. Let's just try this and see what happens. So we should have a lot more firepower now. I guess so has the enemy. Oh, we lost the tank there, but that's okay. We still have plenty left, so no worries. Yeah, we still don't have any Tesla tanks or Prism tanks or anything, but it seems those are reserved for later. But I guess that's not too surprising, because they probably do want you to... Okay, so it seems I did lose... I did actually lose a guy here. So let's go with this, and let's see how that goes. I thought I actually regenerated a tank after the previous battle, but that's okay. We can buy more of that. Still not as interactive as World of Red Alert. Ooh, they did some damage here. But that's generally okay. Yeah, it seems we have reached a stage where we are suffering actual losses. It also seems that our rocket guy there doesn't fire as often as I wish he would, but that's okay. Ooh, yeah, we are suffering significant losses here, so having these extra 50 tanks doesn't really seem to be all that much of an advantage, but that's okay. In any case, I think we're going to end it here, and we'll see how far we get here next time. Thanks for watching, and see you then.